Oh my goodness, we are so happy that you are here joining us this Sunday morning, or if it's some other time, thank you for joining us.
Hello.
And we have Miss Michelle here. Now, I have to ask Miss Michelle something. What do you have there?
Ooh.
Well, unfortunately, my plant is dead.
Oh my goodness.
I forgot to take care of it for a few days, as you can see. Now, I'm taking it everywhere with me so I don't forget to water it.
Good idea.
I'm going to watch it come back to life.
You know what? That reminds me of something. You know, the Bible tells us about how Jesus brought a person back to life.
Wow, that is some mighty powerful stuff.
You know, it is for sure. And there are so many wonderful things about Jesus. He loves every single one of us. He does miracles, and he actually died for our sins so we could go to heaven.
Right. Jesus has power over death. He died and came back to life, and because of Jesus, we can live in heaven after we die.
I know, that is just brings so much joy to my heart. Let's read what the Bible says about the power that Jesus had. We're going to read from the book of John, chapter 11, verse 25. So let me go ahead. I have it marked here so I know where I'm going to be reading from. So we have John, chapter 11, and it's verse 25. Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" So Jesus is saying he has power over death. You know, even though our bodies will die, when we believe in Jesus, it means that we will live forever in heaven. And this is what Jesus meant when he said that he is the life and the resurrection. And Jesus has the power over death and sin, and that, boys and girls, is great news.
It sure is great news. Earlier you mentioned how Jesus raised someone from the dead. Can you tell us about that?
Of course, of course. Let's read again. So it's in the book of John and still chapter 11, but we're going to verses 38 to 44. So Jesus, once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance. "Take away the stone," he said. "But Lord," said Martha, the sister of the dead man, "by this time there is a bad odor, for he has been there for 4 days." Then Jesus said, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said, "Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I said this for the belief of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me." When he said this, Jesus called in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped with strips of linen and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, "Take off the grave clothes and let him go."
Wow, that must have been an amazing event. I'm sure people were shocked and amazed what Jesus did.
Yes, and many people put their faith in Jesus. That was their response to this event. It was just because of his remarkable power.
You know what I learned?
What did you learn, Miss Michelle?
What I learned from the story of Lazarus is that Jesus has power over physical death, but also has power over spiritual death. People are dead spiritually because of the sin in their lives.
Yeah, you know, you're right. But that's just so exciting how Jesus died for our sins. He took the punishment that we deserved. Mm. When we believe in Jesus, when we put our faith in him, when we trust and truly believe, Jesus comes inside of us and he makes us spiritually alive.
There are so many ways that Jesus's power over death works in our lives. Let's trust Jesus for everything we need because he loves us so much.
Yes, boys and girls, let's pray. Jesus, we thank you for having power over death. You are strong and mighty and loving. Thank you for coming to earth to show us the way to heaven. Thank you for choosing us to be your children. Help us to tell others about you. In your precious name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much, boys and girls. Maybe next time we'll see Miss Michelle's plant alive and green. Bye.
Bye.